Sven Dietz.
Avoid. So they want to keep me here inside the circle. So thank you very much for your interest in non-tech talk. We're doing this crazy real stuff. I did a lot of talks already about it, and now we have a reality check. What we have learned the last 12 months, and is there already some conclusions? The first part is to see step by step how we really do it in the projects, live in the reality, and finally a kind of trying to get a conclusion, the six most important things in doing these kind of projects. What I want you to give is the thinking of doing projects different. I mean, this is a Norman Project Island, and normally the one who decides everything is the king, and this is normally the client. But maybe let's talk about a little bit Pippi. Pippi Langstrumpf in German, Pippi Longstocking, really it's the name in English. And yeah, let me see what we can learn from her. Maybe you know the song. It's not so loud, okay. This is a normal Pippi Langstrumpf theme. You have a good imagination. You can imagine how childish and funny this music is. And what she sings in Germany is, ich mach mir die Welt wieder, wie sie mir gefällt. That means in English, I make the world as I like it. I don't know if anybody has a translation for wieder. That means she's doing things different, and she's obviously has a much happier life than the other people in this Pippi Longstocking films. And maybe this magic vidi vidi to make the world as you like it, maybe the real, what we are doing in projects, is a kind of these vidi vidi. Just for those who are here in the first time with the Real Talk, Real is just an abbreviation of raw estimates combined with agile components and lean components. So what did we learn the last 12 months, and what are some of the main steps in a real project? So step by step, just an abbreviation for these who don't know what we do. We do not make real offers. We don't get any orders, because of we don't have offers. We do not make contracts. We do not make specifications. No, you don't need it. In our opinion, it's waste, and almost everything what we did different 5 years ago, as we did usual business stuff, turned 180 degrees to the positive side. So how do we do it? The first is, I mean, many of the ideas you can find in our The Art of Creating Real Values poster, and I think in the afternoon it will be available on our booth. You can just take one of these posters. And the first thing is, does the client fit? Okay? We're not the coolest, and we're not the best agency in the world, and your agency is also not the best in the world. There are some topics you're really cool in, maybe 10% best in your branch in Germany or Europe. Concentrate on that stuff. Do not look for the next turnover. Focus on not the sexy names of sexy clients. Do the stuff you're really good in. And then the client, it's much easier for the client to pay you with a lot of amount of money, because it's worth it for him. And if a customer does not fit to us, we're really not interested in his inquiry. The way we want to do business is to be sitting in the same boat, as we say in Germany, to talk to him on eye level. What we don't like is these, okay, we are the client and you're the agency and it's our wish and you have to do it that way. No, it's our project and we wanted to do it together. And it's a normal behavior of clients doing that, not on the same eye level, but they can learn it, I can promise you. What we do first is we make a raw estimation. If they ask us to give us a huge offer in 6 weeks with a lot of designs and stuff like that, we don't do it. We in just a few days, after talking and phoning a little bit with him, he gets a really, really raw estimation. Estimations do not work, and you know it. I mean, over 90% of all estimations in computer or software belongings do not work. And you know in advance in which direction it won't work. Yeah, it will take longer than expected and will be more expensive than expected. And you know it before and you behave like, but this time this is a real good estimation and we will beat it. No. So don't waste time in all this stuff. Make a raw estimation. And this was the first page what a client gets after 2-3 days. That was the first page and he gets 3 PowerPoint slides or 4. The first one was that one. Then he gets the main numbers. We need that amount of money in 6 months and we think we need 60 modules to fulfill your needs to make a successful project for you. And the modules, they have names. They have no description and they have no specific price. There's just one price for all of it because we do not know in advance which module will be a little bit bigger and which not. And you do not have to know it and you do not have to define it in advance because it will change 6 times inside the project. So do not do it. And this is the last page of the raw estimation, the kind of offer. That's everything he gets. And normally, they are looking for where's the rest. I mean, I wanted to have an offer. And then we call them and explain them how we work. And often it's a very urgent project. So we can start next week. How about that? You will decide in 2 months which agency is the best. I mean, maybe we are already in the middle of the project. No order, no contract, no risk. And this is a normal reaction. No, this won't work. Not in our company. And even if you explain to him agile working, yeah, you're right. But we could not do this. It's against our laws. So explain it to them and then make the magic move. It's just 30 minutes. I can't do any magic tricks here. But So tell him if you have the opinion that he fits to you, then just tell him, okay, we can find out whether it will fit really. Just make a workshop. Do you have time tomorrow or next Monday? We will make 1 day and we will find out how we would work, how we would set up this project. And yeah, it's cool, but how much is this workshop? I know, we are working that way. We would just do it. We don't want an offer. We don't want an order. We don't want a contract. We'll just do the workshop. We send you a list with our hours we needed, combined with an invoice. And if you did not like the workshop, then throw both away because you do not order nothing. No risk. But it's a very quick and easy and open entry. And yeah, maybe they can try it. Maybe they can start that quick with us together. And the poor guy on the company side thinks, maybe I do not have to write these 60 pages of briefing stuff, which I can't do because I don't have so many knowledge about this topic. This is the magic trick. Just be a little bit in advanced work and then he decides how much he would pay. And this is what we're doing the whole project long because we don't have a contract. In 90% of our projects, 95 right now, we don't have any contracts. And we're talking about more than 5 million euro turnover. That means more than 4 million and a half million euro with doing rich, cool, great products without any contract. We invoiced them our time, which we spent, and as long as he likes, he will pay us. And it works so much better than the other stuff. Maybe you have the question how we can do these kind of estimations. I mean, there was a number, 250,000. And maybe, to be honest, we can't do magic. It's just an illusion. And often the question in our company is, how can we do better estimations? How do we know before? You don't know. All the offers, all the calculations you made in the past, the truth was, you don't have any idea. You have maybe a rough range, okay. But whether it will cost 150,000 or 250,000 depends mainly of the behavior of the client during the project. It has nothing to do with your detailed descriptions in your contracts. Forget it. And you know that this is true. So better estimations, there are no better estimations. Try to keep all the stuff lean in the project, then you have a leaner project. And what we want to achieve is to beat the estimation. We are so happy to be under it, to get less money than calculated before. We are paid per hour. That really works fine for us. So better estimation, to be honest, is really not possible. Okay, and you have this cool imagination. This is a song. It's just an illusion. I mean, you know, maybe it's the older ones of you know this song. This is where the estimations come from, really. I mean, just grab in the air and say, I don't know, 240,000, 180, 290, something in between. And don't try to make these this game, this is scientific and this is the accurate calculation. This is not true, this does not exist. So some project managers come to me and say, this programming guy, he always needs twice as long as he predicted, estimated. How can we train him to make better estimations? I mean, it's so easy. If it's more or less always the same, then do nothing. Just know from the past how much the difference is. If you say it's always more or less two times, okay. That means he does not have to learn how to make better estimations. When he says, I will need 4 days, then write down 8 days. I mean, this is true. The first time they asked me, are you sure? Yes, of course, because that would have been worked much better in the past as doing the other stuff. What we do with this is we crash a lot of pitches. We do not participate in many pitches, but we are telling them that we will participate, but then we came after 2 days or 3 days with this raw estimation and offering this workshop, and very often the pitch will be stopped from the client in the middle because he said, maybe this kind of project management system from Zeitgeist is real, is much faster and maybe it's more efficient. Let's give it a try. Then we start with a kickoff workshop. I mean, we think you are the agency, but he does not have to say it finally because he can switch every week, every day. And we, as an agency, we can also do. Fire him off, get rid of him. And then we do kickoff workshops. And what we learned is there you can waste money. It's better to make a more intensive, a longer workshop, to think very often about the spy skills, about this, tell me what you want, what you really, really want, because clients often can tell you which 348 modules they urgently need, but what the real idea, the purpose or the target of the project is, every 4 years there's new money for a relaunch. I mean, this is the main reason. So, but this is not such a good idea to spend that money that way. We don't have too much time, but maybe to write it down, we tried a lot of different workshop formats. Lean Inception is where you can find out what he really wants. It's a good kind, and we do a lot of, we try to do event storming, to talk with him what can be happened in the future, and then you discover all these bombs which are hidden in the ground. And then will be the frozen zone. Frozen zone? oh, I could not do feature injection until the last night. Oh, this is not cool. Better to know it before. And then you as a client, the editors will put in the, we will put in the content. Oh, I mean, all these stuff which you find out 2 weeks before going live. This can be avoided with these kind of event formats. Then we want to know what are his three goals. And it's very hard for him. I can tell you three. I mean, we've written the 24 in our briefing. Didn't you read it? Yeah, but what are the three main things you want to achieve with this project? And it's possible to get them there. I always do it that way. Just imagine I would give you the relaunch as a present. There's just one thing. You do not have more than three goals. You would reject this present? No, you wouldn't. And then with this sentence, he will find his three goals, what he really, really, really wants. And all this special stuff, what would be nice to have, the special kind of navigation or search. Yeah, maybe when we are efficient, when we are very lean and agile during the project, we have maybe the possibility to save all the money, then we can do so many of these Ponyhof, Ponyyard, Sonderlocken. But we don't know whether we'll have enough money at the end of the project for doing all these fancy stuff. And it's better to have a roof on your house instead of having the most fancy door, but do not have a roof. And this is what we call Ponyhofliste. It's a kind of a note block, which is also with this childish design to show him, yeah, we write down all of your cool ideas, but on the Ponyhofliste, the Ponyyard list, maybe we will do it. If you, client, your behavior will be very lean, then we have a good possibility to do some of this list. But first, let's do the navigation, the booking process, the checkout. Maybe it's more important than your fancy ideas. The result of these even larger and more intensive kickoff workshop should be a second raw estimation. The first one was in the language of the client. He sees 60 modules. He's reading, yeah, this is what I need. The price is okay. The time is okay. Well, maybe let's give these fancy, cool reel a try and make this workshop. If I don't like it, I don't have to pay. The results should be the normal things. Okay, after an intensive workshop, you know, this module we don't need anymore. There are some modules which has been discovered which we really, really need, and some will be described different. But with having the goals, the targets of the project, now we're working together with the clients, which of these 60 or 65 modules will be prioritized? I mean, which belongs to your target? And this he wants to do with you, the work. These are important. We want to spend more money on these projects. What he don't want to do with you is then to decide which one we will be built smaller because of maybe the search is so important and maybe then the navigation could be done very easy and very small. He wants to have everything fancy, but everything fancy does not work. Nobody can have a car where everything is the fanciest or build a house where each part is the fanciest available. This house will cost more than 1 million euro. And then you have to harmonize this stuff. I mean, maybe you can try to scribble this a little bit. The most important part of this, and this is one of our latest learnings, to do this together with the client. That means you have these raw estimation modules. Maybe we have here 20 raw estimation modules, and we have the price of, what would we say, 120,000 euro. So, in the name of the client, nobody talked about which one is big and which one not. And now we described in the workshop that some of them we do not need anymore, but some are new. So, and then we have a new module list. And then the new module list, maybe it's in that color here. Okay, wrong. So hooligans. Okay. Then we must discuss what are the targets. Okay, looking at the targets, we know that this, and these two are the modules which are the most important ones. And let's say maybe we have had 120,000 euro and 60 modules. That means from our raw estimation one, the average is 2,000 euro. So, and then we can discuss with the client, the search is more important regarding to our targets. So how important? I mean, an average of a module is 2,000 euro. I mean, the double than a normal module or five times? Yeah, five times, okay. 10,000 euro for this search. That's possible, of course. I mean, he said, I don't have more than these 6 months, I don't have more than these 120,000 euro, and together with the client, we can negotiate what will we do greater, but now, normally 2,000 in average, okay, 10,000 for the search, that means, number one is, he has 128,000, then it's no problem to spend 8,000 more for the search, normally not, okay. Then let's find out 8 modules, which we will build smaller. Just the easy solution. It's not so important how the footer looks like or stuff like that. And this is a really main part because talking about which is important and which he wants to build bigger and more fancy and cooler and more efficient, more great, everybody clients likes. But to talk about which will be do smaller because we spend 8,000 euro more than, and this is just an idea of how we will put the money on the different modules. And this you have to do together with the client. If you don't do it in advance, you talk with them, this is important, you will build this better, but he wants all the modules in the more or less 2,000 euro style, and this is where the 140,000-180,000 projects come from, which has been estimated 120 in advance. Do it together with him, it's his money. And when you start the project, you have to do a real coaching with the clients. This is one of our learnings which we have done much too late, but we're doing it right now. And you have to really do this like Man in Black, all the old school business stuff which is in his mind, we need this and we have to do it that way, throw it away and show him how the ideas are. We are using prediction sheets. That means the modules which are described, now the modules of the raw estimation two are described in a kind of prediction sheet, a cool fancy Excel sheet, the names, and each week we just put in one means that this module is built. Zero means not even started. 0.5, we are more or less half of this module is ready. So it's very rough, very raw again, and we put in how many hours we invested in this week for this project. And this gives us the possibility to make a prediction. An estimation is a guess. It's like playing lotto or stuff like that. But a prediction, if you have some numbers, you can do a prediction. And these kind of prediction sheets. Here you can see that we built a little bit more modules than the average expectation. And here you see with less euro, it really seems not so with a great probability, but sometimes this really happens. We have examples of projects which we have beaten by far. 48,000 was the estimation and 21 was the result, and he saved more than the half of the project. If you save 10 or 20% under your estimation, you are the king together with your client. This has never happened before. And then he's in the right mood to tell his boss what he did with crazy stuff that's real because, oh no, I have a proof that it's really better than the other stuff. As you know, put the special code on the Ponyhof and you have to be strict. This is the thing which is different for the project managers. in the first days, the first weeks, the client always says, no, okay, this is nice, but maybe a little bit darker and a little bit more shadow. Okay, put it on the Ponyo flip. No, I want it, but you have to pay it. If it was my money, I wouldn't do it. I mean, this a little bit darker shadow is more important than the checkout, what we didn't build? No. Don't do it. Yeah, but the client wants it. Don't do it. Do the things which brings the biggest value to your client. You have to be very strict, and this has been learned from the project managers as well. On the other side, you can also waste money or fall back in the old school business behavior inside your company, your agency as well. Maybe there are some project managers who have cool, fancy ideas, show it to the client, you say, oh yeah, this is cool, and everybody's building it, which with money has never described before. So behave as you would build the website for your parents. You have to pay it, but you want to do it as efficient as possible, or as it was your own money. Make it lean, yeah, no house without a roof, and there will be no fancy stuff except the things we prioritize, these modules. This could be done cool. We do not work without descriptions. We described the things on site, the next module which we will build, we are discussing together with the client. And this could be as with him together described. These are the main things which belongs to our targets, and the rest is built in the first round, very small, very efficient, to be sure that we can do all of these modules. And maybe this is not so cool and so fancy, but we could go online and everything is ready, not so fancy, but you can go online, and maybe only 70%, and then there will be some time and some money around, and decide what from the Pony list you will build in the second round. Our learnings are: prepare the basic projects from the additional stuff. We're not doing this list of our hours and the invoice each month. He gets two lists of hours and two invoices. One, what we have used in hours and money for the modules which have been coordinated together with him, and a second list with all these special stuff which pops up during the project, separated. Because otherwise, we had clients who said, yeah, I know that this is a new model and I will pay for it, but please build it. But if he does not know how the separation of the basic project and his nice to have additional wishes are, finally he says, oh yeah, I always said, yeah, I will pay it, but I did not know that it was so much. So separate it and make it very clear for him. And if it could not work, if you have a prediction sheet which shows you that you will need 8 weeks more than expected and 30% more of the project, then talk to him as early as possible. And if your behavior during the project was always talking to the client, this is not important, if it would be my money, I wouldn't do it. If you say this 70, 90 times to him, and it will be more expensive than estimated, then he knows why. Because you said 90 times, I wouldn't do it, and he answered, yes, I know, but my boss wants it. So then he also knows the reason why the price is doubling, but he learns it step by step. And but give him the possibility to keep it small. And if there's a prediction sheet which really runs out of the normal range, more and more. In the beginning of doing real, our project manager was hoping, oh, this doesn't it look good? The client does not say anything. Maybe it will be make the other direction. And the client thinks, oh my God, this does not look good, but Sidecast doesn't say anything. Maybe there will be some movement. No. Yeah, the principle hope do not work on this. This will be the direction of the price if you do not escalate. That means then we have a budget delta meeting, and if you do it after a third or a half of the project, you have so many possibilities with the clients. That means I have to close. That means just an example from the last month. There was a project and it was predicted to 50% plus in money. And we do not have to protect ourselves. It was the fault of the client, and he knows it. And we said, okay, you know these prediction sheets. I think you want to minimize these plus. So we have a list of 38, 55 small things which we can kick off or build smaller than thought and described before. Then we can stay inside, or you organize more money. And then it's also working together with him. And these things really, really work. And the thing what we think was essential for our base is we have cross-functional teams. And if you have questions to these six last things, come to the lounge and ask me. No departments. Please do not do departments. Then the leaders, they have, in our side, we have the question, can we make ourselves unnecessary? This is our main question, what we have to give the teams the chance to make their own decisions, less management, less micromanagement. So the CIOs work on your company, and be on focus. Give the people the possibility to work focused. Yeah, no small things, no interruptions. Make special rooms for them where they are protected from everybody, even from you. And where the focus goes, the energy flows. I think this is really right. And you have to coach it. You have to coach it to the people and to your client. And what we do is to focus some small sprints, not 2 weeks, maybe a day. Just get the key, no interruption, and your efficiency will double. Try to keep it as small and lean inside the project. I mean, we can build it bigger if we end with 70% of the budget, when we have 30%, and then we can decide what we will make bigger. Small timings are good. There is no possibility for the people on the team, and also not for the client, to make all, even think about all these fancy pony of stuff. Agile, for us, is a core value. And we are getting a lot of inquiries and jobs because we are so radical agile. And yeah, this is what we are doing. And if you're interested in how this could work also with your clients, I'm very interested to have a discussion. But give it a try and just do it. The only thing which maybe could be a barrier are your doubts about it. We already made coachings and trainings for agencies, and there is no problem for other agency to do the same stuff, and it works really great. And well, finally, it's more fun for the people, better projects, and we earn a lot of more money in doing this kind of projects instead of the normal old school business projects. Give it a try and start next week. Thank you very much.